me up, I've been calling you. It's 2 a.m. and I want you to shot from the bartender. I wanna ride with you. We can be more than we meant to be.
It might be this time.
Welcome back to One on One with Honey. Today I've got a very special guest, Liam Charles from the Great British Bakeoff. Whoa, whoa, whoa. So how are you today?
I'm good. It's a little bit cold though.
It is cold today. Yeah. Like the weather's just like plummeted. Like
I've got really bad circulation in my hands as well, so it doesn't really help. Yeah.
Really? Oh no, you need to get some gloves and stuff like that.
Get some gloves later on.
So let's talk. Let's talk about British Bake Off. How a young guy like you get on there?
Yeah. So I was about 16 at the time, and like my household, so like me, my mum, sister when she used to live there, had like a massive sweet tooth in it. So we'd go to like Sainsbury's and get like, you know, like the cheesecake slices.
Yeah.
And like, you know, the desserts that you put in like little pots and get those all the time, microwave, whatever. And then I used to watch like loads of food programs as well. Mm. But I thought to myself, I can probably do this. So I started off with like cakes first. And then like, I remember the first cupcakes I ever made, they were like these green icing cupcakes, lemon. Mm. Yeah. And it had like red squiggles on it. And like, they were disgusting. But obviously, you need foundation, didn't it? So like, that was like the start off. And then from there, I went to like biscuits, bread, pastries. So that happened. So I was doing it for a couple of years, and then it was in sixth form.
Okay.
Well, I was starting to bring in my bakes from every weekend. So every Monday I'll bring in my bakes, and my head of year was like, do you want to do your own bake? So I was like, okay, cool. Yeah, I'll do that. So I did it, sold out, which was sick. And I did it again, reinvested the money, sold out again, which was mad.
Oh, so you know about investing all the way back then, yeah?
100%. And then obviously I was a graphic student as well. So I did my own branding, and then it was called Cheeky Treats and that. Mm. So that was really cool. And then my head of year was like, have you ever considered doing Bake Off? So I was like, wow. I was like, I'll always watch it, innit? But yeah. I was like, at the time, I don't think I was good enough. Do you know what I mean? So I was just like, okay, whatever. And then it was my first year of uni. Not a lot of people know this. So the first year of uni, I actually applied, but I left it so late, like the day before applications were closing. They didn't call me back.
Aww.
Yeah, it was the L. But then I spent second year grafting at it, you know, practicing like chocolate, all like, you know, choux pastry and all like very like niche sort of disciplines in baking.
Yeah.
And then, that summer. And then second year I applied, and then 1 minute I did application and I get a call when I'm in like the field of uni. You're part of the Bake Off. I was like,
wow.
I was gassed. But like the whole thing with that is, so obviously there's getting on it, which is sick. But then now there's 10 weeks of it, isn't it?
Yeah. But when you're doing that, do they have to taste your pastries or anything like that?
Oh yeah, no, they have to taste your stuff. So
during the application process?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So it starts off like online.
Okay.
Typey, calls, bear calls and that. And then you go meet them.
Okay.
And you try their stuff. No, they try your stuff.
Yeah.
And they say, oh, what do you think you could do better? So critically analysing your bake.
Mm-hmm.
So that happened. And then, I was on it. I was like, what? It was sick. It was really good.
Well, being on Bake Off was great for you.
Yeah.
Like, how did it feel as a young black boy? You know, black boys, we don't really see them as bakers.
That's true.
Did you get any comments about that, or was there anything around that? How did you feel as a person as well? Like,
I mean, to be fair, when I used to bake for like family functions, especially on my dad's side, because everyone was like, you know, like football, because my dad's family is like massive football fans and like, you know, IT and whatever. So when I'm coming across with my Victoria sponges and that, they're like, you know, it was a bit like, what?
Yeah.
But then they looked at it in the sense where I'm being constructive, I'm being like using my time constructively.
Yeah.
So everyone was really supportive.
Yeah. Yeah.
But when it came out that I was on the show, like it was mad love, apart from one dude, So I was in Upper Street.
Yeah.
And this guy said to me, I'll never forget, he was like, Oh, when I first saw you in the show, I hated you. Yeah.
He said that to you.
I swear down. I was like, okay, you're being truthful, like whatever. Mm. So I was like, why? He's like, I just couldn't understand someone from Hackney. Yeah, that's what he said. Someone from Hackney and being the age that you are and being from the background you are, mm-hmm. why you bake. So I was like, it was just, in my eyes, you're just ignorant. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
but then
he goes,
oh, but I saw you achieve and blah, 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 blah. But why does it take for me to achieve to sort of recognise what I've done?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Or for you to accept baking as like something that a black boy should actually do. Very interesting.
So that was very interesting. And he was like of like black, like ethnicity or whatever. So I was just like, fair enough. But it didn't stop me doing what I'm doing.
Yeah,
so
it shouldn't. And I just hope that a lot of other black boys hear that, because as you said, it shouldn't stop you from doing what you want to do.
Sure.
I feel like a lot of people stop doing what they want to do because they're scared of how they're going to be perceived by their peers.
And that's the thing, because, you know, everyone, don't get me wrong, a lot of people do like music and stuff like that. And that, if you're great at it, do it.
Yeah.
Like, don't be afraid to try something that's a bit left.
Definitely.
Because you can start your own thing.
Exactly. Definitely. But you came in fifth, which is great. But a lot of people thought you were robbed. So how do you feel about that? Do you feel like you should have gone further?
Do you know, it's funny because like when I was practicing for that week at home, I was practicing the cake. I said to my mum came into the kitchen, and she was like, I said to her, I think this might be my week to go home.
Wow.
Because so, but this was my flaw, because I preempted that I was going.
Mm.
So once you do that, you've put in your head that you're going regardless.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I said to myself, when I first entered the town, I was like, I don't really care if I went or not. It's just like it's not for banter, yeah, because obviously this is a serious
thing. Yeah.
But I was like, I'm just gonna enjoy myself and I'm doing what I love.
Mm.
So I firmed 8 weeks. So I was like, okay, cool. Bye. I woke up the next day thinking, oh, I've got to practice. I was like, oh, wait, I don't. Bad.
Wow. Wow. So you think power of the tongue is...
Yeah, you got to, like, and that's what I say to some of my boys as well. Like, so obviously they want to do, like, different things and stuff, but you just have to speak it into existence.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
100%. 100%. Yeah. How was it kind of working in a tent? Is it a tent, right?
Yeah, it's a tent. It's in a tent, like, in the middle of, like, country, like, where there's sheep.
Wow, how is that? Because, you know, like, when they say you cook, sometimes you cook from love, which makes you cook even better. So knowing that you're not at home in kind of your comfort zone, in your kitchen, how was that?
The first week, I was all over the place.
Really?
Fact. Like, so my first bake was like an apple crumble loaf, The first 5 minutes, like, I cut myself, paramedic had to come out. I was a wreck. But it made me look good in it. So I was like, okay, But once you like it, you know, like with anything, the more you use it, the better you get.
Yeah, yeah.
So after the first week, I was like, okay, cool, calm my nerves. Second week was decent because that was biscuit week. Mm. And then bread week was awful. I hate bread so much. So then I went home, and because next week is caramel, and caramel is my thing, innit?
Okay.
So I was like, okay, I got to pattern up for that. And then from week 4 onwards, until week 8,
right.
Obviously.
Yeah. But since Bake Off, you've had some great success. So your book, Cheeky Treats, tell me about how. Why did you think to write a book after?
Do you know what? I actually didn't think about writing a book. But like, it was one of those things, like, when I was young, I thought, can you imagine having a recipe book? But I never thought about actually doing it.
Yeah.
So obviously I got someone to represent me,
mm-hmm.
and then they were like, oh, there's quite a few people want to, you know, publish your book and stuff like that. I was like, okay, cool. But for me, writing is like just doing bare essays, and I don't like essays.
Yeah, you know? I know. I prefer exams to essays any day,
I prefer
personally.
Neither, but you know, you've got to do them, innit? So there was that, and we had a meeting, and then, but luckily enough, the publishers, Hodders, they share the same vision.
Okay.
If there was going to be a book, so I was like, okay, let's do this. Book came around, and then originally, because everyone was calling me Cake Boy, innit?
Cake Boy, that's your nickname, right? Like, Cake Boy.
Yeah, but then like someone else is called Cake Boy, innit? And he's like well established, so there's like loads of legal issues and that.
Oh, cool.
So I remember I was on set for Bake Off the Professionals hosting that, and then we had to change the name. So then I called it Cheeky Treats because that was the name of my first bake sale. So it went running a full circle, do you know what I mean?
That's so cute, I love that. I really love that. Like, that's really cool. But it's great to see that everything you envisioned as a younger has come into fruition.
Which is weird, but
crazy. But when you work at it, obviously you've mastered kind of your baking. You took the time. You took the time to do it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's true.
Of people at your age wouldn't really do that. Yeah. But tell me about your presenting and Channel 4 and all the how's that going?
Mad move. Yeah, that was
a maddest move.
That was crazy because so it's the same production company who make Bake Off.
Okay.
So again, Vivian, the one that looks after me, she's great. There was like, oh, there's potential for you to do Bake Off the Professionals. Because on BBC, it was called Creme de la Creme.
Okay.
So it's like, you know, hotels going against each other and stuff like that. So there was a potential for that. I was like, what? I said, if I get, because I watched it in it when it was with BBC in it. I loved it. Yeah. Because you learn like new techniques from them. I was like, okay, if I get this, crazy. So I had to do like a few screen tests with like different like presenters and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Weeks on, keep on doing these screen tests, keep on doing the screen tests. Wow. And then like, and then Vivian caught me. She's like, you got it. I was like, what? Gassed.
Wow.
And then, so I'll do it with Tom Allen, that the comedian, brilliant guy. And then again, with Bake Off, the first week, I was pooing myself because it's like, you know, because now you're going from a baker to, you know, you're a host now.
Yeah.
So it's a completely different ball game.
How did that change? Like, how did you kind of maneuver yourself into that role?
So I knew for a fact I had to bring like a professional side to me.
Mm.
So obviously I'm still being myself. I'll be myself regardless of where I am.
Yeah.
But you know, now you've got to do, okay, chef, so you've got to make 24 such and such, such and such. You've got to sort of command authority.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Whereas in Bake Off, you just do whatever, innit? So that was fun because you learn how to talk to people more.
Amazing.
You know, you learn like, you just, yeah, it's really cool. And you get to eat loads of stuff.
Oh, I bet that's your favourite part, isn't it?
Some of the pastries, yeah, because these are professionals, isn't it? So we had people from Hilton Hotel, Hotel Cafe Royale, like proper prestigious hotels to come in to bake. So it was mad.
So what can we expect from you in the future? What's the next plans? What's your next move?
Oh, God. Okay, so my own show just finished.
Yeah.
So that was great. I got season 2 of Bake Off the Professionals.
Perfect.
So we filming that soon, and everything else, I'll get assassinated if I say.
Oh, really? You're gonna do me like that?
Sorry.
No, but thank you for taking time to speak to me today. Like, your story is actually amazing, and I think it's very inspirational to others. But if you do have a last word of advice for anyone who does want to step out of the box and maybe not do the kind of stereotypical thing that people expect them to do, what would you say?
I'll just say you just gotta be your biggest fan.
Mm-hmm.
Because once everything's done and once you've started it, remember, you're always going to be there.
Yeah.
So you just got to believe in it and like just speak everything into existence.
Amazing. Thank you so much for coming on One on One with Honey with me. All Liam's details will be on the description box. I'm going to put all his details in the description box. Go and get yourself his book and, you know, find out all his great recipes and stuff. It's amazing. And I do want some cakes soon from you, okay?
No pressure.
But thanks, guys, and see you next time.